And now, believe it or not, it's me again. This time, I have a great pleasure and honor to introduce our first keynote speaker at this conference, Mr. Mikhail Shvydkoy, who is a special representative of the President of Russian Federation for International Cultural Cooperation. He's a Russian theater critique, we are very glad to know that. Drama, social, and political activist. He was director of the Moscow Theater Musical and worked at the Moscow State University. He was also Russian Minister of Culture from 2000 to 2004 and chairman of the Federal Agency for Cultural and Cinematography. Last but not least, if you allow me to say this, to put it in these words, Misha Shvydkoy is a friend. And we all call him Misha and not Mikhail Shvydkoy. He knows a lot of you, among you. And Misha, we are very glad to have you
with us. Thank you very much. I will stay. You know, that's the best advertiser in my life, you know. At least 10% of all my profit, you know.
Super, thank you. It will go to BITEF Festival.
Dobry день, dobry dan, good morning. The Honorable Minister of Vladan Vukasavljevic, Honorable Minister of Karina Sute, distinguished guests, ambassadors, ladies and gentlemen, friends. This is a very sentimental feeling to be here for me because when I came first time in this building in the 1979, I came to Beka Vuce office with Dragan Klaic. He was alive this moment. Dragan teaching university and not dream about the Amsterdam Theater Institute. He was a chairman of Netherlands Theater Institute a long time. And we asked Becker, please give us some tickets to show. And she said, no, I have not all booking and it's impossible. And, you know, this impossible forget.
That's how she was.
Because be guest during the BITEF, it was a great, great happy for all of Russian critics, because this was a real point where we met with the foreign theater, the Western theater, and this was a good chance to meet all friends from the Eastern countries. You know, when I first time I went, the Mira was absolutely admired person. Of course, she was a great manager, she was a great leader, she has a strategy of the future, but she was a great lady. She kept the absolutely unique sexual power, and all men around her was as a shy guys, you know, and looked to her. When she go to the Belgrade street, the car stops, you know. This was absolutely unique. I know the another one lady, there was Ellen Stewart from La Mama. But lady, the Ellen was a Afro-American, we know this word since the 1970s. She was a great black woman, and she was, Mira was a great white woman. And they around there, they concentrate all the work, you know, all theater work. Jovan was a very special man, and he was absolutely intellectual, so when I saw him, I immediately was a very great the Polish poet Konstanty Delfon Galczynski. He was a sentence, the intellectuals unhappy race in the old railway station. I repeat, the intellectuals, the unhappy race in the old railway station. He was, every time when I looked to Jovan, he was unhappy. what he feeling inside, nobody knows. But I ask him, "You are Jew?" Because I am Jew, but I am much more happy, you know, than you. we have an old joke. Why is a Jew never drink the analgin, analgetic? Because he won't keep the ill inside. And when I watch the Jovan, I ask him, listen, I must be unhappy. You must be happy. You work in the best festival in the world. You know, the Russian steps of Russian impact in BITEF was quite serious. And BITEF was a great impact to the Russian theater culture, of course, theater process in the 60s and the 70s and the 80s. And this reason why in the 1999 was absolutely crisis situation in Belgrade and Serbia, when NATO drops bombing the Serbia, and I was the chairman of the national broadcasting system, and my staff was in Belgrade, and I called to CNN people and asked where will be the next bombs, you know, because I try keep my stuff. This was a crisis, and in the 1999, the all most influential or most famous Russian theater people sent a letter to Jovan. We invite the BITEF in Moscow. We understand it's absolutely impossible to make a creative festival during the military under the bombing, you know. And we sent the letter. Jovan, if you want, we try organize the BITEF the one time in Moscow. He said no. He said, thank you very much, I'm very appreciate, but I won't keep the BITEF as a Belgrade place. And this was absolutely right step. Because Jovan understand BITEF and Belgrade, this, you know, something, this is a symbol of Belgrade. This was a symbol of real Belgrade with a human feeling, with a human fundamental value, with a real theater understanding of the world. This was a much more than theater, you know. This was a mission. This was a mission for Mira, this was a mission for Jovan, and this was a mission, I don't know, explain why. This is not just, this is absolutely simple way to say it. This was a crossing point between the East and West. No, this was a place for meeting of the all real city people, all people who keep the real democratic feeling of life, who keep the real feeling of human value in the world. And for him, it's very important to keep this festival in 1999 in Belgrade. This was the main reason. You know, during the millennia, when you said about CIA money, I think about KGB money, but I hope this is my mistake, you know. Because you must understand, this is very important. Mira, I think, was some kind of reincarnation of Osip Broz Tito, because the main producer of festival was Broz Tito, of course. Because without him, without his will, without his understanding of the role of theater, center of theater in Belgrade, it was impossible. But he was a very clever man, and he understood this place must be center where crossing varieties, political, cultural, and civil society movement. This was, as we said, third way in the political during the Cold War. And I repeat, he finds the absolutely right lady. Of course, Mira was absolutely independent. Mira was absolutely free. But at the same time, he has a very good umbrella. Because politically, for Yugoslavia, the BITEF was a very important center of concentration, varieties, powers. And of course, for Russians, this was very important. Because during the first festival was where the Akhmadulina and Akudzhava, they were our great poets. Mm-hmm. And they were here during the first festival in the 1967. And of course, for all the great director of the Russian, for Lubimov, for Tostanogov, for Ephoros, for Petr Fomenko later, Lev Dodin, etc. All big Russian performances were present here because everybody understand. If you in BITEF, you're in the theater, in the world theater process. If you present your show in the BITEF, this means you're part of the world theater culture. And this was very important for all of them, especially during the Soviet period when there was a Cold War. You know, thinking about Mira, I think she died in the 1989 where the Berlin Wall ruins. And this something symbolic, you know. She her mission in the life there was a ruins the Berlin Wall, you know. And when wall ruins, she left this world. This absolutely symbolic act, you know. And for me, she creates a new world without walls. And this was very important for her. You know, the 1967 was a very interesting period, the middle of the 60s. This was a great period, a powerful period of theater. In Poland, the Konrad Swinarski was here. The Polish theater was miracle. The Czech theater, Atamar Krejcia, and Czech movie, and Czech literature, everything was, this was before Prague Springs. This was a great period for Hungarian theater, for Russian theater, for Yugoslavian theater. This was a great period of Yugoslavian theater. Even the 70s was a period of the real development of the eastern part of the theater world in Europe. Even 80s, you know. And, you know, the young Yugoslavian, the 70s was a young Yugoslavian director as Ljubiša Ristić, for example. I don't know, now everybody destroy all relations. I speak some names and afraid if something not have something say no. Mister, I'm sorry, but friend of, you know, I met Borka in the middle of 70s in Moscow, you know. This is a great period of life, you know, absolutely different time. I repeat again, the Russian presentation in BITEF was very important, the same as BITEF was important in Russian life. Yes. Until now, we are continue feeling this BITEF as a real center of the theater culture. And of course, I'm happy that's not mine. This is Becca. This all my girls, they keep the phone on, you know. This reason, you know, you have a very complicated period, of course, now. Because if you remember, the BITEF was founded in, the Avignon was founded in the 1947, I think. Yeah. The International Warsaw Festival was a little bit later. But the BITEF was unique because BITEF was in Yugoslavia, and Yugoslavia not be east part and not be west part. Now, fundamental future, and I, as we are alive, all Russian theater will try. This will be honor for us, be in BITEF, and I hope this will be long time. And when you will without us, well, you make a celebrate 100th anniversary of BITEF. I hope the, somebody from Russia will come and repeat my words.
Thank you very much for such warm words and for giving, putting some light more from your private perspective and from your memories to what were the first years of BITEF. Now I have the honor to present to you our second keynote speaker, Hugo de Greef, who has been the general, who has been the general manager of the Kai Theatre in Brussels. He was the general manager of the European Capital of Culture in Bruges in 2002. From 2007 to 2010, he was the general manager of the Flagge Art Center in Brussels, who was center regrouping all NGOs and civil society. He co-founded the one of the most important of European theater networks, European Theater Meeting, IETM, the European House for Culture, and many others. He's the president of PARTS, a dance school in Brussels, founded by Aunt Teresa de Kersmarket, which was on BITEF, of course, as many other Flemish artists, and president of Passaporta, the House of Literature in Brussels. Currently, he is co-director of the Europe for Festivals, Festivals for Europe platform. He was Secretary General of the European Festival Association 2004-2008, and today the General Coordinator and co-founder of the Festival Academy. And as our conference has in focus on one side, BITEF as such, but on the other, festivals and their importance in contemporary life, we invited Hugo de Greef for the second keynote speech.
Yeah. Thank you very much. It's a real pleasure, and I'm, of course, wishing from the European Festival Association happy anniversary.
Thank you very
absolutely.
Much.
It's absolutely an important day, 50 year. The number is impressive, but what's even more impressive is the history itself. It's explained already, of a festival during decades of change and challenges. And if one compare this with, for instance, and it has been said already, Avignon and Edinburgh, they are both in their 70 editions. As a striven, after the Second World War, those festivals contributed in a search for peace and living together in a destroyed Europe. BITEF in 67, and then also in that same decade, a very important festival, Festival Mondial de Théâtre de Nancy. I will say, as a young guy, I visited both of the festivals in the 70s, and they inspired me to found the Kai Theater in 77, and that was like a real new package of festivals in Europe with, for instance, a lift in London, in Teatro in Polverice, and so on. BITEF remains important, here international. But it's interesting how the nature of this importance was different in all these decades. It was already all underlined by different speakers. And how it is today to find a specificity and an international position. A struggle, but as well an interesting challenge for every festival indeed. How to stay relevant in a world of the arts that have seen already everything, embraced by a democratic society, and for many European countries, although financial crisis, living in an economically satisfying civilization. Look to our bigger colleagues again, Edinburgh or Avignon. How to keep the role of guide in international theater renewal for a festival as Avignon? How to remain an example in the choice of classical music linked with contemporary creation as Edinburgh? Although they are all till today outstanding festivals with a strong program and an excellent exposure, but where is the uniqueness? It has been focused already by the earlier speaker. Where is the role for looking for the arts of tomorrow and the artist changing our way of perceiving creation? I think that is an item for this Congress, also very interesting to elaborate and to see further. Therefore, I'm curious for being present at the debates of this Congress. The themes are relevant for the arts today and for the role of festivals tomorrow. A festival is a location, an environment, and a setting where artists can present their work with a large degree of artistic freedom. The public goes to a profiled festival more readily than to the regular culture supply in search of an unfamiliar or of the innovation. The success lies more in the challenging artistic creation and the unusual experience that in the pure consumption of culture. A festival is also seen as a factor in culture tourism with particularly relevant economical effects. When the cash tills are closed at the end of the day in bars and restaurants, the local economy certainly feels a difference the presence of a festival makes. Even if the economic added value is no more than a striking side effect, it cannot be ignored when it comes to defining the added value of a festival. Festivals provide the context for excellence to be innovative by giving artists the opportunity to create or to present themselves for an audience that is open to experimentation and the avant-garde. It is mainly through festivals that new trends and other forms and expression are accepted by a broader public. The role of arts festival is to program or even produce experimental work, since it is there that new forms gain acceptance. That's clear. Although culture diplomacy, the theme of this Congress and geographical position. Although arts festivals' main mission is to give the artist exceptional opportunities to create and to present, their sense can be broader indeed, as offering to the audience the possibility to enjoy new creation, to be confronted with new visions and participate in unique moments of beauty. It brings cultures together. The European Festival Association, as the crucial network in Europe for the festival, is taking these basics as their message. It leads the dialogue in the projects in collaboration between the members, but between the members, but indeed art festivals are at the same time a platform for meeting and exposure. Used within diplomatic programs, it offers each culture an environment to make contacts easier, to start or to permit constructive dialogue. One has to be clear. Festivals are instruments in cultural diplomacy, yes. It's the challenge for a festival to incorporate the offered program through the promotional channels of the diplomacy into an added value for creation and for public. Targets set out by cultural diplomacy programs must be integrated within the artistic ambition of the festival. It's only condition for being successful together as a festival program and as a tool in diplomacy. It's not about using culture for diplomatic reasons. It's connecting culture for better understanding. It's not using culture because that can lead to excluding cultures. I think it's an important item for this Congress. The European Festival Association meets through their different activities and programs very often, official representations of national institutions for culture diplomacy. Their support is not only welcomed on the budget level, of course, it's as well useful of a source of information and knowledge. Certainly in the IFA training programs, as you may know, the Festival Academy. The young generation of festival organizers are facing a strong concurrence and an extreme challenge to look for the need and the personality in the artistic profile of them. We invite the young generation in programs as the Atelier for Young Festival Managers, the Festival Production Training Program, and others to go into debate and discuss where for each of them the necessity of their work for the artist and for the audience can be positioned. How to deal with culture diplomacy needs an opportunity is part of finding a balance to make a festival possible, to serve the audience by serving the artist, and to connect between cultures. And to close my introduction, I would like to comment a little bit on the program from IFA that has its pilot edition from the Europe for Festivals, Festivals for Europe project, an EFE we call it. In EFE we try to bring together festivals in Europe with a certain quality. It has to do with culture diplomacy and geographical tension. Selected them based on three essential elements: artistic program, local importance, and international position. This is the base of the program. We could bring together 760 festivals from 31 European countries with the help of many national partners and more than 100 experts and an international jury. They're all brought together in the book. Some of you may know it. 760 festivals all over Europe are presented. A lot of text goes with that. And we could make the pilot project supported by the European Commission, the European Parliament, and BITEF is part of that, a lot of Serbian festivals of that. It's my pleasure, Mr. Minister, to give you already a
Thank
copy.
Thank you very much.
I have some copies for more of you. If you are interested, please come to me later this afternoon. We know what we wanted when we launched EFE, to give a voice to festivals and the festival community in the exceptional work they do every day, somewhere in Europe. We want to invite and involve as many festivals as possible and to acknowledge their quality. And we wanted a program that is beneficial to all those involved with festivals, artists, directors, visitors, citizens, the media, politicians, as well as a program to strengthen the culture project of Europe. For us, it was important to also give a sign that Europe, first of all, is a culture project. So that was the basic line for us to say those festivals can be instruments in the talk, in the debate, to underline that Europe is a culture project. Today, when festivals are being killed off by questions about their economic impact, when their values to society is measured in facts and figures, a program such as EFE is about the story of festival tells, the mission is pursue, the added value it gives through the work of the artist to a place in time to the people that participate in it. It gives room to the arts, the artist, the magic and the inexplicable, the unknown and the discover, the surprising and the recognized. And I can announce that 2 weeks ago, the European Commission decided that EFA, European Festival Association, can go on with this project, Beautiful Festivals, Festivals for Europe, for the 3 years coming, 17, 18, 19. So we will work on the program further, and we will have the possibility to give more platform, as we're speaking, the platform as festivals in the future. Festivals are visions in society. I thank you.
Thank you very much for the pleasure.
My pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you.
I thank everyone, our Minister Vladan Vukosavljević, Goran Milošinović, President of the Serbian Committee for UNESCO, and our keynote speakers, Mikhail Shvydkoy and Hugo de Greef, of course, the artistic director of the festival, Ivan Medenica, for their speeches in this morning. And especially, I would like to thank you for mentioning our dearest colleague, Dragan Klaić, who, in fact, also led for a long time debates within BITEF, so he was very much really linked to BITEF, but in the same time, he was initiator of the European Festival Research Project, and after this project, a lot of books and publications about festivals has been produced, and that's a good moment also to give some memory to him as a very important theater scholar for Belgrade, for Serbia, and former Yugoslavia. So thank you all very much, and now I invite you for a coffee break. And after coffee break, we are going to have to continue our work, but now relax, and thank you all for participating.
Thank you very much. Yeah, maybe on Sunday.